Are you looking for a quick and easy way to start monetizing your website? Well, keep watching. In this video, I'll walk you through how you can add Google AdSense to your WordPress website to start earning money quickly. And don't worry, if you run into any issues, I'll also share a couple of frequently asked questions and a couple of solutions if you run into problems while installing it. The first thing you need to do if you don't already have it is you need to apply for a Google AdSense account. Open up a new tab and go to the google.com/AdSense website. From here, you can sign up for a Google AdSense account, and it typically takes about 6 to 8 hours for an approval process. Once you've been approved, simply log into your dashboard for Google AdSense, and over here under My Ads, we can create a new one to get started. Now that you click on Add Units, let's click on a new ad unit. And from here, you can choose from three different ways to do it. I'm going to show you the text and display ad. That's the classic way that most people have done Google AdSense. So we'll select this one. You want to make it a descriptive name so that you'll know what this is. Some people do it by where they're placing the ad. And down here, you want to choose what the size of the ad you want. The responsive one is really good because it will expand or contract according to what the end user has. If they're viewing it from their smartphone or their tablet or their desktop, this will expand to show it properly for that person. You want to test different ad sizes because different ad sizes will probably mean different amounts of money for your website. A lot of people recommend the 336 by 280 rectangle and the medium rectangle 300 by 250. Both of those seem to do pretty well for many websites. So I'm going to click on the 300 by 250. For the ad type, it either will just show text or an actual image to a person. By default, they recommend to show both of them. Again, with many other things, you'll want to play with this to see which one works best for you. But you can typically start with the display and text ads part and then change it as you go along. So we're going to keep it as that. The text ad style, we'll click on that. You want to pick the ad style that looks the most like your website. So scrolling through, you can pick the one that looks the best. If you don't see any that looks as close to yours as you can, then you can also click create ad style and you'll create a completely brand new one and you can match up the colors to match with your website. Once you pick the one that you want, then there are two other items that you want to look at. The custom channels area is simply a feature that allows you to better track your ad performance. So you can choose to do that now. Since you're just getting up and running, it's probably a good idea to just wait until later. The if no ads are available, that's crucial to know what you want to do because if Google can't find an ad to show your visitors, then you need to tell Google what to do. By default, it will simply collapse the ad unit or show a blank area. And when you first set this up, that's actually what you'll probably see in the beginning because it can take a little bit of time for the Google ads to start appearing on your website. We get that error a lot. People think it's an error. They're like, I just installed this and nothing is showing on my site. What's wrong? Well, it will take a little bit of time for Google to show the ad. And when that's happening, you'll see a blank area. The other two options you can do is you can collapse the unit and show color, a different color that you want maybe from your website. Or you can also show another URL. If there's an image from somewhere else that you want to show, you can do that. We're going to stick with the default. We'll just have a blank space if nothing is available. Now we're done with this particular ad. So we want to save and get the code. And you want to copy this. We want to keep it asynchronous. That means that your website will load regardless if this ad will load. So it's very good for speed and for the user experience. So we need to select all of this. I'll right click and copy. Now that we've copied it, we need to add it to our website and we'll do that next. From our dashboard, the absolute simplest way that you can do this is by adding it to one of your sidebar widget areas. So to do that from our WordPress dashboard, we'll head down over to Appearance, go to Widgets, and what we want to use for this is we want to add the custom HTML over to our sidebar. And put that there. Under the content area, I just want to right click and paste it. And now we'll save it. Now that we've added it to our site, we can take a look and see what it looks like on our website. Now looking on the website, you see that there is a blank area. That's because we just put it on here. So it will take a little while for Google to match some ads to show on our site. So it could take a little bit of time for this to show up. But you can see that after I refreshed my page, my ads are finally showing up on my site. So now that you've set up your first one, go ahead and go back through AdSense and create a few more ad units so that you can start testing and improving your results today. Did you learn something from today's video? If so, subscribe to our YouTube channel and we'll send more helpful tips to help you manage your WordPress website. And thanks for watching.